All right, man, I'm here at the 930 Club with Opiate for the Masses, who just did a kick-ass show with Seven and Ron. How you guys doing?
Doing good, man, hanging out.
Excellent.
Okay. I got to say, to be honest with you guys, I hadn't heard of you guys until I got in touch with Jen from the publicist. And you guys put on a kick-ass show tonight, man. And I think one of the reasons I like it so much, and, you know, I can't believe I'm going to say this, but it's music, it's metal music that makes me shake my ass, all right? And there's a lot of ass to shake, so is that something that you guys wanted to do differently with your band? Did you guys want to put, like, I guess, like, dance moves or, like, you know, kind of like a little bit of techno stuff in your music?
Yeah, for sure. I think it is a conscious, of course it's a conscious decision, you know what I mean? And the kind of stuff that, I mean, all four of us are into different kind of stuff, but the one thing that we all have in common is we do like the four on the floor kind of dance music, whether it's ABBA or Rammstein or anything in between, you know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, come on, guys. No, hey, I did a great show, man.
Yeah. We'll edit it out.
We'll fix it in post.
Thank you, darling. Thank you. We'll fix it in post.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. That was my thought.
Pretty much.
Yeah?
We are.
Okay. So, the one thing I like about you guys also is the look that you guys have on stage. It's a lot different from a lot of bands that are out now. You guys kind of remind me of, like, the Euro-style bands, not in sound, but in kind of, like, your dress. Is that something that's important to you guys? Like, the image, is the image side important as well as the music?
Yeah, I think a lot of bands are lacking a certain look or an image.
Total package.
Yeah, a total package thing. And we took the name Opiate for the Masses, which is a Karl Marx quote.
Right.
And we just ran it into the ground, basically, because he is tied in with basically everything Soviet and all the Soviet history. And we have, like, everything is a satire on the Soviet imagery. Like, the backdrops are all like propaganda posters, basically, and we're just running it to the ground.
Even the logo, which is, you know, the variation of a sickle and a hammer.
Well, that's what I was wanting to ask you. I knew that was Karl Marx, so I was going to ask you if that was just a joke you guys are running, or is it Opiate for the Masses that you take from the quote, or is it your band is, you want to be Opiate for the Masses with your band?
Well, it's definitely derived from the quote, you know what I mean? Originally, that quote was pretty much a slap in the face to organized religion, which we definitely agree with. But that's not to say that we're communists or that we necessarily agree with wholeheartedly with the entire, you know, socialism, communism kind of vibe.
Right,
but there are aspects
right.
of it that make a lot of sense.
I think we chose the name because it was... it made people think. It made them wonder, what are these guys about? And as soon as we said, hey, just think for yourself, that was enough for us to go, hey, that's a cool name.
Mm-hmm.
And it stuck.
Yeah, that's the one thing I got from your show, and what I liked about tonight was that you guys, like I said, you have a modern look, but I also, it reminded me, because I'm, you know, brought up on the 80s style music, and you guys kind of got that California edge. I know you're from California, but you've got that California, like, vibe going on.
Yeah.
So is it important to keep, you know, your roots from where you're coming from?
Yeah, I guess it is. I mean, a lot of, as far as on stage, the on stage kind of imagery has a lot to do with our wardrobe designer. It's got Todd Waters, who runs a company called Junker Designs, and it's all handmade, badass, leather, kick-ass kind of shit. And he works with us and Buck Cherry and Motley Crue and Aerosmith. That definitely has something to do with it, and a lot of, like Ronnie touched on earlier, a lot of, you know, the huge backdrops, the sickles, the hammers, the everything.
The propaganda
aspect of the World War II kind of imagery is played in with it, you know, I mean, even
right.
if you look at the album cover.
As far as the LA reference, that's where we all met, but our bass player is actually from Sweden. He's from Dallas,
Texas,
and Jim and I, our guitarist and I, are both from Phoenix, so a little bit of redneck somewhere in this kind of regalia,
yeah,
you know?
Sure.
Right. Well, see, I think that's one of the things I liked about you guys when you came out. It was like you guys had that fun vibe going on, and that's what a lot of things are missing nowadays. We talk about this, we talk about it all the time, about how the band, there's so many bands that are copycat bands.
Yeah.
And the one thing that you guys, when I got on your MySpace and went on your the other page, you guys, it's like you're coming up with a different vibe. And that's what I like. So I think it's really important that bands like you come out and try to do things like this, because especially like in rock and metal, a lot of things get stale.
Yeah.
So where I was going with that is just thanks for doing that type of music for us, because there's a lot of people that like that style. So tell us about the new album that's coming out, man.
Well, it has a lot of different elements in it. It was produced by Ulrich Wilde and John Travis. And Ulrich Wilde, you might know him from Static X. He worked with Alice in Chains, Pantera, worked on Far Beyond Driven with them. And John Travis actually worked with Kid Rock on Devil Without a Cause. He was nominated for a Grammy for that. And as well as the Last Book Cherry record and Sugar Ray. I mean, so we feel really fortunate that we got to work with those guys.
Right. I think that their influences as producers were just as wide as ours were as a band.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a really cool collaboration. And so I think the sound is just as original as the stage show that you just saw. Like, it's something that people will go, you know, not initially, like certain people like certain things. Those people might go, what the fuck is this, originally? But at some point they're going to go, I get it. And that's kind of the generalization of the album as well.
Well, yeah, I saw it tonight. When you guys first came out, it was kind of like everybody was like, okay, you know, I don't know what's going on. And then as you guys kept getting into it, everybody was just getting into it. Start, you know, again, going back to the ass shaking thing, everybody was just, you know, getting into it. So was it as fun making the record as you guys have on stage?
You know what? For me, record making is very intense, and it's just as fun as it is excruciatingly painful, because you want to get it right, you know what I mean?
Right, and you have to live with it forever.
Yeah. When you're on stage, you can get away with really bad stuff, and sometimes people never know.
Right.
With the record, it's always scrutinized, so you got to be you got to exercise the same kind of observation and scrutiny on a record.
Yes, so there's always pressure, you know what I mean? Right. Self-imposed pressure as well. And, you know, working in a new bass player, you know, Anna Kay was new to as far as this record, and trying to work all that out, and, you know, having
this song. She's right here, right? This is Anna Kay. Hey, how are you? Good job tonight.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Your food is a big rock bomb.
Okay.
But trying to work, you know, because she's a songwriter as well as Ron and Jimmy, you know, and so trying to work all these aspects in and self, like I said, self-imposed pressure as well as pressure from, you know, your lawyer and your manager and your label and this and that and the other thing. And at the end of the day, I look at it, me personally, I look at records as just a tool that facilitates touring. You know what I mean? But
right.
I think all of us have a different look at it. You know what I mean? Like all
right,
of us kind of have a different like opinion about it. It's not right or wrong or whatever. It just is. But we're all pretty happy with how it turned out. And just ready to be on the road forever.
Right. Well, how do you guys feel about? I mean, with this, the way the state of, I guess, record labels in general, or the whole industry is going.
Yeah.
Downloading is obviously a big thing, and it's caused a lot of record sales as far as metal too to go down.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something that when you guys are making records, does that concern you at all, or you just care about getting out on the road and just making music?
Yeah, because when we all, like, when he was coming up and doing his thing before he was in this band and I was doing my own thing, we had that old model that we looked forward to.
The major label.
That's gone.
The bus.
Right.
The thing,
but what happened was indies were able to thrive in a certain environment where the majors, basically the indies are the rodents, the you know what I mean? They might not do the biggest, most amazing things, but they're alive.